Celebrate Jesus, celebrate. One behind you, my friend.
Come up this
side.
One up there.
Where the bishop?
Just come up more.
We're looking for somebody to sell the grace for the food.
Oh, Heavenly Father, this evening for bringing us here as we come another day, Lord, to celebrate, to rejoice with our sister who has lived. You have spared her life to see a long time. As we come this evening, dear Lord, we ask for your blessing. We ask that you would undertake, and as we participate in celebrating the life of our dear sister, we ask that the Holy Spirit will have full preeminence, and at the end of our coming together again, we can say it was good for us to be here. We ask this evening, dear Lord, that you would bless each and every one, and help us, Lord, that everything will be done according to your will and pleasure, and at the end of it all, we can say thank you Lord for the many blessings that you have blessed us with. We ask, dear Lord, that as we participate in the meal that you have provided, that you would bless the food, Lord. Bless the tables as we celebrate, as we participate, as we take the food that you have provided. We pray, Lord, that everything this evening will be done according to your will and pleasure. We ask, therefore, Lord, that the Holy Spirit would have full preeminence, and at the end of it all, we can say, thank you, Lord, for all that has been said and done. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Amen.
Mario Waters. Mario Waters, grandson. Come.
Good evening, everyone. Welcome to Hugh's 90th birthday celebration. I must tell you how great it is to see so many of you at my great-grandmother's 90th birthday celebration. Please enjoy the rest of the night. Thank you.
Right now we are going to have a scripture reading by Sister Elaine Edwards.
Congratulations, Grandma Eunice. The bookmark I have in my hand says, she's virtuous. She's royal. She's a queen. She is Eunice White. Congratulations again, Grandma. Ooh. After 90 years. A reading from Proverbs chapter 31. And I'll begin at verse 26 to the end. It says, she opens her mouth with wisdom, and in her tongue is a law of kindness. She looks well to the ways of her household and eats not the bread of idleness. Her children arise and call her blessed, her husband also, and he praises her. Many daughters have done virtuously, but you excel them all. Favor is deceitful and beauty is vain, but a woman who fears the Lord, she shall be praised. Give her of the fruit of her hands and let her own works praise her in the gates. The word of the Lord.
All right. Seems as if everybody is sleeping. If you're not sleeping, let me hear you say, happy birthday!
Happy birthday!
If you're happy to be here, say, happy birthday!
Happy birthday!
And if you're really, really, really happy to be here, Now we are going to have an item by Bishop Tibbin Scott. Is he here?
Alright. Why should I feel discouraged? And why should the shadows come? And why should my heart feel
suit you. I bet you. I'm going to play one song for you now. Hear? And if it suits you, just hold up your hand and say, praise God. Amen, sister. Run the track, don't we?
Thank you.
Beautiful. Give him another round of applause for me.
Yes,
he did well.
Thank you, Mr. Harold. Okay, going through our program. Right now, we're going to have someone who I know is anxious to come and talk to you or sing to you or whatever he's going to do for you and surprises you, and we're all waiting. And now we're going to have Brother West. Give him a round of applause. $100 water club, please. May I have to go $5,000? Who would you mean low this spot, Miguel?
That's right.
Ready? Mr. Ashley, wanna get to all of my money? All right, welcome, Brother West.
Well, somebody love the Lord, say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I was about to ask her. Somebody love the Lord,
show me the lady whose birthday it is.
I can't believe that this woman is 90. Now, I'm bothering you just to shake your hand a little bit. And I hope the ladies beside you don't get jealous, but will you permit me to kiss you? I like to kiss nice ladies. And you're the nicest one here tonight. Could you give me a troops and majority, baby? My God. Now, give me another one. I don't know how could you just move your daughter to me, please. Sometimes you got to stretch hard to get it right. Thank you, mommy. Thank you very much. You people. Read up for me, please. The soldier. Mother, this is for you. When you're tossed on life's seas and the waves they cover you. Bring up the soundtrack for me. And the dark clouds won't let her sunshine through. That's when a voice seems to say, Mother, there'll be a brighter day. Don't allow storm clouds to hide heaven's view. Mother, you've got one more valley, one more hill. And maybe one more trial, one more tear. One more curb and slap's road. Maybe one more mile to go. You can let down your heavy load when you get home. Somebody give the Lord a praise. Come on, give God a praise. Give the Lord a mighty praise. Oh, blessed be the name of Jesus. 90 years, my God. Now listen to me, Mother. Now don't let Satan see your fears. Learn to smile through your tears. Hold your head up high and give the world a little smile. You better be faithful all the way. It's gonna work it all someday. Cause it all gonna be over in a little while. Oh, you've got one more valley, one more hill. Maybe one more trial and a little tear. One more cry. Life's road, maybe one more mile to go. You can let down those heavy loads when you get home. Oh, you got one more valley, one more hill. Maybe one more trial, mother, another tear. One more curb and slash road, maybe one more mile to go. He can lay down your heavy load when you get home. Oh, I'm gonna lay down those heavy loads when you get home. We're gonna lay them down. One day we lay them down. Lay them down. If you love the Lord, give the Lord a hand. I don't know if it's because you're hungry, but I want you to know one thing. Holy, holy day. Holy day, holy day. Brithday. We're getting there, I was just going to do that one anyway. But you know, we're not going to be here forever, you know that. You didn't know that. Oh, when you're looking at me like that, you never know we're not going to be here forever. People are dead all when I'm 25 and this woman lives in 90. You should be giving God more praise. Not true? The food's already, man. Give the Lord more praise, no man. Clap your hands and praise Him. Give the grandchildren and the children and the great grand. Walk with her, walk in her step. Everybody agree with me?
Yeah.
I'll give the Lord a praise, man.
Yes.
A long last road I stumbled in the darkness. My blinded eyes, it had caused my feet to roam. But she met the Lord, and He spoke to her so sweetly. Come walk with me, then I will see you home. Come walk with me, she said, the road is straight but narrow. Children, come walk with her, 'cause you cannot walk alone. Though the road is rough and there are so many dangers, come walk with her and He will see you home. I'll give the Lord a praise. If we walk with Jesus, day by day, I believe it in my heart, like grandma, God will see us safely home. If you believe that, shout hallelujah, somebody.
Hallelujah.
Somebody give Him another praise again.
Hallelujah.
Oh, blessed be the name of Jesus. Let me do this last verse, please. My love. The road is rough. It's been real hard for her coming up. And sometimes along her way she stumbled. And sometimes she wondered if she could make it. I just guess when she was about 65 going 70, maybe 75 going 80, one would think that it's all over for her. But my God, this woman passes 85, 87, 88, 89. Now she's 90. Give the Lord a praise. I made that up a while ago. Come walk with me. Though the road is straight but narrow. She said, come walk with me. 'Cause you cannot walk alone. Children, the road is rough and there are so many dangers. She said, come walk with me, that I'm gonna see you home. And all for 90, we give the Lord praise and thanks for her. And we trust God to give her much more time. If you agree with me, somebody say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
You see her home. Amen. If you ever get that song, you won't hear those H thing coming down in it. You learn that one. God bless you.
Beautiful, sir. Beautiful.
He's going on.
on with Jesus and she can't turn back. Though some folks don't go with her, she just won't stop. You may say that she's not perfect, but then so what? She's got Jesus on her journey, that's enough. See, I know this journey ain't no easy ride. She's got heartaches, pain, and sorrow, can't be denied. But one by one she leaves them all behind for a better place with Jesus she has found. She's going on with Jesus, she can't turn back. Come on, people. Though no one calls with her, she just won't stop. You may say that she's not perfect, but then so what? The woman got Jesus on her journey, that's enough. Jesus told her he'll never leave her. Well, he told her he'll be with her to the end. Though sometimes she feels alone, but he's still there with her. I thank God she's still her Lord and dearest friend. Oh, she's going on with Jesus, she can't turn back. Though no one go with her, she just won't stop. They may say that you're not perfect, but then so what? Mama, you got Jesus on your journey, that's enough. But I know sometimes in life she gets disappointed when the ones she's counted on, they let her down. But don't lose hope while traveling this pilgrim journey. In the end, Mama will hear, "Welcome home." She's going on with Jesus, she can't turn back. Though no one go with her, the woman won't stop. You may say that she's not perfect, but then so what? Ah, Mama got Jesus on her journey, that's enough. She got Jesus on her journey. Clap your hands and praise the Lord tonight. She's not in the hospital. She's in her right mind. She can hear. She can see. And she's about to numb. Oh, did I say numb? Oh, you might as well just hit that one. Give a lot of praise, everybody. Well, she's going on with Jesus. Turn back. Oh, no one calls her. Mama won't stop. They may say that she's not perfect, but then so what? God, the woman that's on her journey, that's enough. Mama got Jesus on her journey, that's enough.
Give a lot of hand to that. For a woman 90 years, and I'm a fasting people business. I see rice and peas. I see chicken and curry something. Don't know what it is, and I see some white little thing look like salad and vegetable. And people that eat to drink through straw. You don't believe me? And the woman did that. She won't eat, yes. She ain't going to have me.
Yeah.
Selector. Selector play for dance. She's my selectress. And I call her sweetie. Secondly, don't call her selector. Secondly, I didn't say anything before, but I will spend most of my time at the table that I get the most clap from. And so far, at this table over. Yes, sir. So I'm sorry for her. And thirdly, dear, I wanted to play that song again for me, please. And after that, I wanted to play Lady in Red for this lady who I don't want to sing and clap. Run the track, sweetie.
Problem and you don't understand. We all need somebody to
thank you.
birthday to Grandma Eunice. We all know she's 90, she's batting well. And we're going to sing. We're going to sing the nice one. Happy birthday. You right? Who know that one? Alright, so we're all gonna sing that one after two. One, two. Happy birthday to ya. Happy birthday to ya. Happy birthday. Happy birthday to ya. Happy birthday to ya. Happy birthday. May the good Lord bless you. May the good Lord bless you. May the good Lord bless you. After 90, don't it? But just let's give her a round of applause. Woo! And I'm gonna say all of them that clap, they wanna just go past 90, don't it? Yeah. Alright, cause we're gonna make a more than 10, how go? Yeah, alright. So what we're gonna do now, we're gonna have our money. Watch out. I've realized that when the first one was lit, everybody went around the table, you know. Grandma used to come and say, oh, I'm not going to say happy birthday. Hey, Grandma, you just throw Now we have gone through that, so now is the time that we are going to have Grandma cutting her cake, her beautiful cake, and... Alright, so she'll be cutting it with her granddaughter, Rosie.
Yeah,
so, Grandma, you and Rosie are going to hold the knife. Right, and after three, you'll be cutting your cake. One.
Two. Three.
Two.
Three.
Three. Yay, give her a round of applause. Shy. I don't know why I clap. My feet don't know still not clap. But watch me out, Uno. Watch me out, Uno. Because I see right now, me want everybody participate. And always shy at the first person who want to come up here.
I know Grandma Eunice, I love you so much, you know that. Hey Eunice, you know I'm sleeping, so I'm not busy with her. And of your time now. But Grandma Eunice, I love you so much. You have been my grandma for years, and you have lived to see 90 years old, and I hope that you will live to see many more all every day. You say, Lord Jesus, me not think me can manage no more. Cause I'm peeing. But no worry yourself, you're about 90 and you're not ready for out yet. So I wish you a happy, happy birthday, and I hope you live to see many more. All right? She hear me, but she charm out just, you know, she quiet. All right, so right now, I want somebody who braver than me, who have a lot of fun. Walking like a young man. I'm gonna get to real so they reach here. I just want to thank you all for coming and celebrating my grandmother's 90th birthday. And I also want to wish her all the best and that I love her. And even though she have not seen me like how a granddaughter should see a grandmother, I still love her and she's still in my thoughts. So Grandma, I'll do better. I love you. Happy birthday.
No man, clap her. She never do this. Yeah, clap her. Of course. Hey, I should have stopped.
You don't know why I get something tonight?
Alright, then I'm going to ask a question. We're going to have Brother West, who is going to come again and pass up the place.
Give him a round of applause if you know I hear him. If you didn't love him the first time, I'm going to love him even more. Maybe hear it. Alright.
Well, I don't know what she meant, but I'm going to do what I should do. Is everybody feeling good?
Yeah!
I'm not going to sing for you right now, but I'm just going to say a few words. But I just want you to not only hear, but listen. So if you're talking to somebody, tell them wait till later. Yes, no, she's talking with me, don't worry. Now, we gather here tonight. I've never met this woman before, but I'm privileged and I'm very happy to meet her. And I know we're enjoying ourselves and that is very nice. But there's one thing I want to leave with us tonight. As we go through these gates, or through this gate, those of us that will go, I think I hear some people here chatting. They're going to tap their eyes. Thanks. When you're talking, I like when you talk. You can't make me feel bad, you know? I mean, easy to vomit. Yeah. Good. Back to the road. Every one of us that leaves through here today, tonight, leave either with Christ or without Him. We live today, we're not certain of tomorrow. Grandma, great-grandma, mother, friend, she lives to see 90. I don't reach there yet. I hope to, but only God knows the future. What I'm simply saying to us tonight is make sure we find Jesus as Savior before it's too late. Do I get amen from around the back there? Am I talking foolishness? Now, I don't come to talk to you about the name of your church you go to. That means nothing to me. But your relationship with God is most important. When I leave here tonight, I hope to go home and I really hope to go into that little cold bed. It's cold now because nobody else is lying on it. And I really hope to go there and I really want to sleep. But only God knows if I'll reach. So the future is in the hands of God. One little scripture I leave with us, and I said us, not with you, just you, but us. Psalm 23, and a little part of it said, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. Just that is enough for me tonight. All I need to know is that God is my shepherd. Therefore, I must follow Him. It's not Him following me, it's me following Him. I'll encourage my unsaved friends. relatives, loved ones, to grandma, that you will find the Lord as your Savior and Maker and soon come in King before it is too late. These are just a few words. And for those who claim to be Christians, don't just be a name Christian, but live the life so that others will see the Christ in our living. These are my few words to you, just to encourage you, and I'm glad for this opportunity. You know why? Really and truly, I take life very, very serious. Time won't permit me tonight to tell you how close I've been to death. In God's Spirit, my life 5 years ago took me from way down nothing and bring me back. The same God that brought me through will keep you through. Whatever your situation, whatever your problem, believe me, brothers and sisters, friends, God is our shepherd. Let us trust him tonight and follow him. God bless you.
Amen. Thank you, Brother Wes, for that encouraging words. And I hope that we all listen.
Yes.
And take heed.
Yes.
All right? Because we don't know what tomorrow brings.
That's right.
Right? So I do thank you for that last word to take us through that gate.
Very well.
All right. So now we are going to take two more toasts. Just two more. Let me see the bravers. Where are they? Who wants to give a toast to Grandma? Don't let me start calling you, you know. All right, go in once. Go in twice. I am going to call. Amen, sister. Come, walk up. Dorit, come here for a minute, please.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Good night, everyone. Tonight I must say to God be the glory. Great things he had done. Eun is my favorite aunt. Two aunts, and she's my favorite aunt. That's my mother, sister. I love her so dearly. When I was in the country, I always go and visit her. And when I spoke to her, she always encouraged me, and it motivated me a lot. Now that my other sister, that's my mother, have passed away at the age of 81. And I'm so happy that she had lived to see 90 years old. And mommy, I know if you were alive, you'd be here tonight. But may your sweet soul rest in peace. Aunt, I just want to say a happy and a happy birthday to you. And may God may ever live, help you to live to see even one more. God bless you, and I love you. Keep sweet in the Lord.
All right, one more. If I'm not coming, I'm going to go home. One more.
Come on, man. Come on, yeah, man. Come on.
Hey, brother, man. No, I only heard from one man.
Yeah.
Okay, see more on the floor.
All right, everyone.
Nice, man.
Thanks for your guy and coming and everything. And happy birthday to my mom. She's been there for me from ever since. My father died when I was 9, and she be my father and my mother together.
Yes.
And I hope she may live to see me anymore. God bless you, mom.
Nice one. Nice one.
Thank you, for the picture.
Winding down, you soon be off. So we are coming down to the end of our program and a wonderful evening here. And now we are going to have a special prayer and close off by Elder Garfield Christie from the Lynn State Gospel Hall. Is he here? Okay, give him a round of applause. Come on, clap him on. We need the prayer to go. We need that with us, brother. With us, just give us some encouraging words. Now we need our prayer.
Be here to celebrate 90th birthday of Miss White. Now this morning I was at a funeral service for a young man 25 years of age. And I was saying to myself, why this young man have to die so young, but he died. And I'm here this evening to celebrate 90 years of life for Miss White. It's not easy to live to see 90. Many people die at very tender age, but for you to live 90 years, you must have done something good, and the Lord must have blessed you to see 90. So congratulations to you, and hope and trust that you'll live to see many more years to come. Amen? And we're going to pray. Our Father and our God, we thank you again for this privilege that you afforded us, that he could have gathered with his family to celebrate the life of this dear one who have lent us for 90 years. We thank you for those who put plans together to think of those who provide the finances to do this feed. Lord, many times we want to say things when people are gone, but we thank God that this family took time out when this person was in her right mind and could have listened, could have eat, and could have laughed with us. We thank you for each person who traveled, some travel from far, some travel from near, some travel from even overseas to be here. We are at the end of it all to now, and we are about to journey home.
Go with us, Lord.
We pray, Lord, that you might be with us, take us home in safety,
every one of us.
And that we might continue to praise you,
yes,
in light of all that is happening.
Amen.
We continue giving you thanks in Christ's name.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, sir.
Amen. Did we all have a good time tonight?
Yes.
Did we all have a good time tonight?
Yes.
Did we all enjoy the food?
Yes.
Did we all enjoy the entertainment?
Yes.
Did we all enjoy ourselves?
Yes.
And now it's time for, you know what? Vote of thanks. We're done. All right, so we're going to ask Dorrit to come and give the vote of thanks. And as she come by, the drink who has drink to drink, be merry, be happy, she's coming. Okay.
I am overwhelmed to know that tonight it is not a repast that we are serving
nice,
for.
Nice.
Or this is not a dead yard, but it is a celebration of life. And the Douglas family, with so many other family related to my grandmother, can all be here celebrating her 90th, that we are so privileged and blessed and extra rewarded tonight to have our grandmother 90 years and don't even want to sleep or complaining to go to our bed. So we are thankful. There are a couple persons that I personally want to thank. Like, was the food good?
Yeah.
Was the meal good?
Yeah.
Why is the people so boring? Why are we not talking? Why talking to the person next to you and not responding? You didn't enjoy all of this?
Yeah.
But I'm not hearing you.
Yeah.
I want to put your hands together for the cooks. I don't know if Chin is nearby, he's my brother-in-law. Emmanuel, Mackie, Sister Rosie, and all who was around the back, doing that all day, cooking and preparing for this moment. I want to thank you. They did it all with their hearts, and they did it with love and with appreciation. So everybody that puts into the food. Not to mention the waiters and the servers. Dalton, Fitzroy, all of my cousins there at the table. I just want to thank you. There are also the lady who, a friend of mine, she's not here, she's in Miami, but she gave me the key to go to her storeroom and to take all the utensils I wanted. Even though she is not here, I must be her, Mrs. Richards. I want to thank also all the person who chips in, my family member. My brother, he was so much on board with this. You, my grandmother, have two grandsons in Canada. I must apologize for them not being here. Orette and Sheldon, they were the one who insisted that we do this together. Amen. As a family. With all the grants putting together to make this night what it is. I wanted to big up and give Orette and Sheldon, even though they are not here, but they are here right now, just seeing everybody, and even though they are not physically seen, but I know that their art is right here now. So I wanted to give Orette and Sheldon, who chipped in greatly to this night. I want to thank all the cousins who came on board one way or the other to make this a success. The musician, was the music good?
Yes!
The saxophonist, was he good?
Yes!
Would you want him back?
Yes!
At your function?
Yes!
Or was the MC?
Woo!
Did she be good? So there's so much to be thankful, but more last but not least, I want to thank our Savior, the Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Who give us a good day, a fair day, good health, protection to come here, and he's going to give the protection to go home. So we want to big up the Lord God, who gave my grandmother 90 years to be here. So all praise, all glory, all honor goes to the Kings of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Thank you all for coming, because without you, it could not have been tonight. So I want to thank you all for coming. Safe journey back.
I know it's not nice to let her go so easy.
Amen.
We want to give a very, very special thanks to Dorrit,
amen,
who seemed to be the chief engineer behind this setting. Give your hand a clap, give them all a clap of it for her. Yeah, I have to do that. Yeah. She worked so hard. I hope somebody's going to pump her to bed tonight and see that tomorrow morning she gets breakfast in bed. And nice her up, let her stretch out and give her a little massage and the necessary things. She deserves it. Let me move from here, she feel warm beside me. God bless you.
Have a good night.
Enjoy the rest of the evening. Thanks.